Are you tired of writing multiple scripts to update related or reference recording service now? What if I told you there is a simpler, cleaner way? Today we are diving into two powerful glide record methods, update with reference and insert with reference. That will streamline your scripting and save ton of your time. So let's jump right into it. Before that, let's have a quick refresher. What is glide record for the people who are new to ServiceNow? Glide Record is a ServiceNow scripting API that lets you interact directly with database table. You can query, insert, update, and delete record easily using Glide Record table. Okay? Let's start with update with reference method. This method allows you to update a record and its related reference field simultaneously without writing separate script. So what are the benefits of it? So it reduces scripting complexity because you don't have to write two glide records, okay? It ensures data consistency and save development time. So let's imagine updating an incident and the caller's phone number at the same time. Isn't it amazing, right? Okay, so let's look into that. So I will just go to incident.list and let's pick any incident. So what I'll do, I will just select this particular incident out. Okay, this particular incident, and let's see what's there in the Able Tutor. So Able Tutor don't have mobile number. So we want to update the phone number for him also. Okay, so I will just open and I just want to grab the technical name for it. It's mobile phone. Or we can update the phone also. Let's business phone we want to update for this particular user when he is creating an incident. So what I'll do, I will just go connection lost. I'll just go again on incident. I'll just refresh it out. What's happening? Okay. Perfect. Now this is the incident. Now our use case is like, we want to update the shop description for this particular incident. At the same time, we want to update the business phone also. Okay, in one script. Isn't it amazing? So we'll just use background current. Okay, so that we'll get the context of it in the background. It's loading. Okay, perfect. Now we have js.info, let's let it be. And now how we can do that is, first we'll be doing current dot short description. We want to give it like, okay, this is a new short description. I hope this is perfect, right? Okay. And at the same time, let's do current dot caller ID. Now I'm updating the reference field. Okay. And we have seen it was phone. So I will give phone equal to, and I just want to give my number 90. Okay. My number 90961212XXXXX. I will just replace it with 0000. I don't want to give my own actual number. Perfect. And at last, what we can do? We can do current dot. What is the function name? It's update with reference. Perfect. So what it should do? It should update the short description. Our expectation is it should update the short description. At the same time, it should update the phone number also. Okay, let's run it out. If we run, we see incident got updated. Perfect. And it also updated the user table. Isn't it amazing? Let's see, is it amazing or not? So I will just go back. I can see the new short description. Perfect. Okay. And I can see the phone number also got updated. Isn't it amazing? If we have to do it before, we have to write two glide records, okay? But now we don't have to do that. Let's look into the fog. Let's next explore the insert with reference. So what this method does, this method lets you insert a new record along with its related reference records in one go. Okay. So benefits of it, it again simplifies complex insert operation. We don't have to write two glide records. It automatically creates related record. This is amazing. Okay. And it enhances script readability and maintainability. So for now, what we'll do, we'll try to create an incident. At the same time, we'll try to create a new user. Isn't it amazing? I really like this thing out. So let's first confirm that particular user is not there. So I'll go in the user table. Okay. And let's search with name. I'll just remove this out. And name. Or I will go with what? Username. The field is username. And if I go with the technical names, I just don't remember. Username, name. We want to update username, name, and email ID. Okay, let's do these three fields. Okay, and I will do it for a person name. Yeah. My wife. Okay. Her record is already there, so I will just go with Divya, my brother's wife. And it's not present. Okay. So we'll try to insert the record over here. So again, what we'll do, we'll just go to the background script, okay? And I will just remove all these things out. And let's try to write a code. So I will give variable incident equal to new glide record. Okay, perfect. And we want it on incident. This is good. Then we can do incident Chia incident dot initialize, because we want to create a new record. Yeah. And we can give what Chia incident dot short description. I will give this is a fresh new incident. Yep, perfect. Now I will be setting the caller fields. Okay. So I can do Chia incident dot caller ID dot what? User name. I want to give it as Divya G. I will just Chia incident dot caller ID dot name. I want to give as Divya Gujarati. What as Chia incident dot caller ID? We have decided email, right? Email. I want to give what? divyag@gmail.com. And we have to do Chia incident dot insert with references. Now we are inserting, and if you see, the glide record is entirely written on incident table. No, where we have written sys user table, right? Now, if I run this out, let's see what happens. If I run, we can see what insert. One insert happened in the user table and another one table affected. Okay, fine. We will check that also. Okay. And let's check. So I will just first go to incident. And you can see this particular incident. Isn't it amazing? This is a fresh new incident. Caller, it was not there itself, okay? But it got created. Divya Gujarati. If I open this record now, we can see the information Divya Gujarati, okay? And the email ID is also populated, right? So quick tips, To keep in mind, always validate records exist before updating. Use try-catch block for error handling. Test script thoroughly in development environment first. Okay, don't try to do these kind of things in prod directly. Okay. And that's how you master glide record with references in ServiceNow. If you found this helpful, hit the like button, subscribe for more ServiceNow tutorials, and ring the bell icon to stay updated. Got question? Drop them in the comment below. Happy scripting. Thank you.